Day 75. Today, Maimonides once again talks about the obligations a husband has to his wife. Namely, three things that a husband must be sure that he fulfills for his wife. Number one, that he provides her with food. Number two, with clothing. Number three, with conjugal marital relations. Yesterday, we spoke about the literal meaning of those. Today, I wanted to take it one step further and discuss a little bit more of the spiritual aspect of these three items. The food that he is required to provide her with is compared to Torah study. It is something that enters us, just like food enters us and becomes one with us, becomes a part of us. So too, the Torah that we study is something that should enter our beings and become one with us. Number two is clothing. Clothing is something that is outer wear. It's something that does not enter us. It stays around us, over us, it envelops us. And this symbolizes the mitzvahs that we do. The mitzvahs that we do create a certain godly light that envelops us, that surrounds us. It doesn't necessarily enter us, but it surrounds us. While the conjugal relations symbolizes prayer, that is that one-on-one time, that intimate time that we have with God, that quiet seclusion, just like man and wife have, we get to have with God. And just to even take this a little bit further, it is also with our relationship to God. God, just like food, surrounds, or rather fills every single one of us with a godly spiritual light. We each have that spark of godliness within us that gives us the power to fill our potential. Every single one of us is given the life force that he or she needs. That is that, like that food that sustains us. Just like the food sustains us, God sustains each one of us with the appropriate amount of light. Number two is that light that envelops us. You know, sometimes a teacher can teach the student and it's something that is so clear and so real and you understand that and it enters you and it makes so much sense and becomes a part of you. And then there are those times when it just kind of remains a little bit hovering. It's just a little bit higher than our pay grade, just a little bit more than we can exactly comprehend. That's that second type of light that God creates around us that just kind of hovers like a garment. And then there is the third kind. The third kind is occasionally there will be a brand new revelation. Just like when a husband and wife are intimate and can potentially create a brand new soul, a brand new creation, so too, occasionally, God will give us these bursts of intellect or these bursts of brand new revelations will appear on this earth. The timing of a woman is called onata or ainasa, her timing. That's the time that a husband and wife can be together. And the same wording is used for the days of Mashiach. We are told that Be'ita ba'achishena, in its time, I will hasten it. God is speaking about the coming of Mashiach. In its time, I will hasten the arrival of Mashiach. And again, in its time, that's when the greatest revelation of all will come to its potential, will come to its peak in the days of Mashiach. May it be very speedily. Have a wonderful day.